Will you now please refer to your lineup sheets for the starters for today's game? For the U-O-I-T, Ridgebacks, in goal, number one, Bryce O'Hagan. On bench number 77, Chris Purvis. On bench number 10, Dominic Silvorak. And left wing number 57, Luke Van Berger. At center number 67, Jesse Stone. And at right wing number 12, Brendan Lyons. The Ridgebacks are coached by Marla Mueller with assistants Justin Carolina, Rob Russell, and Dave Brown. And now the starting lineup for your University of Guelph Gryphons. In goal, number one, Brandon Maxwell. On defense, number two, Ken Parra. On defense, number three, Daniel Grossard. And left wing, number 12, Brent Papio. And center, number eight, Matt Vile. And at right wing, number nine, Jordan. Our University of Guelph Gryphons are coached by Sean Camp with assistants Chris Clancy and Dave Billick. Ladies and gentlemen, would you now please rise and remove your hats for the playing of our national anthem.
Welcome Gryphon fans, and also a warm welcome going out to all those Ridgeback fans also joining us on SSN Canada. My name is Stefan Peterson. I will be bringing you all the action live here today from the Gryphon Center. Starting in net for today's teams, we have starting in net for the Guelph Gryphons. It will be Brandon Maxwell, and in response, the Ridgebacks will be going with Bryce O'Hagan. So both teams coming into this game, the Guelph Gryphons will be currently ranked third in the OUA West, while the OUIT Ridgebacks come in ranked seventh in the OUA West. As we are just underway here, face-off one here by the Ridgebacks. Played back to the defense, it's Purves back over to his defense partner as they try to move it through the neutral ice. They do now, coming on, and his first shot is steered away there by Maxwell. Battle along the corners. The Guelph Gryphons trying to move it out. It's kept in there by Purves. Getting to it first is Peroff, who plays it off the board to Appio. Appio trying to move it out. Can't get by. Now back behind his net to get it. And moving up the wing to Mock. Mock coming out of the zone for the Guelph Gryphons. Loses it at neutral ice. Gets it back momentarily. He's going to try and play it. Deflects off his own player. And that's going to be cleared down into the Guelph Gryphons zone. Maxwell, long breakout pass here, trying to catch the Ridgebacks on a line change, and that didn't get to his player, and so that one comes all the way down to the OUIT Ridgebacks goaltender, O'Hagan, who just covers that one up. So the Guelph Gryphons coming to this match are red hot. They have won their last six matches, including a game yesterday against Waterloo, 2-1. That was a close one. That one was actually in a shootout. That pass is intercepted at neutral ice, but taken away there by Patches. Played around by Maxwell. On the board is McDonald, who plays it up for Appio, trying to hit Merritt there. Merritt sends it around. No one home as the Ridgebacks take it back. Now coming up on the breakout, here come the Ridgebacks. Back the other way, send it around the net. Right there, and a shot on by Berlada. And that one's going to be corralled by Maxwell. OUIT also played their last game against Waterloo. They did not fare as well as the Gryphons did, losing that one 6-3. Back to the play here as the Guelph Gryphons try to move it into the OUIT zone, but that's going to be taken away there. Now back behind his net and moving out with it. Ridgebacks finally getting it into the zone, but it's going to be corralled there by the Gryphons. Moving back out the other way, Jeffries makes a nice pass. And that one's going to be fired low on goal, and no rebound given up there by O'Hagan. Face off one here by the Gryphons. Quick shot towards the net, but that one won't make it through. Up along the boards is Woodcroft, who wasn't able to get it out. Now he does, and this is going to be played to center ice. Broussard manning his man in the neutral ice zone there. Ramsey trying to take it towards the net, trying to slide a pass through, and that was going to be steered away by Maxwell. Penalty upcoming to the Gryphons here. They finally touch up the puck, and we'll see what we got here. Looks to be a slashing call going against the Gryphons. And it looks like it will be going to Broussard. A couple of new faces in the lineup for the Gryphons today. Captain Edward Gale is still out of the lineup with a supposed leg injury. So we'll get our first look here at the Ridgebacks power play as racing for it is Gavora. Gavora can't get there. Nice opportunity there on the power play, on the penalty kill for the Guelph Gryphons. Misplay there as the Ridgebacks turn it over, and here come back the other way are the Guelph Gryphons. Turning with it is Gavora. Gavora trying to keep control of the puck, loses it, and now it will be brought back the other way. Here's Van Morkirk. So the penalty to Broussard is for holding on the play. That is why we now have the power play here as developing for the Ridgebacks, as for once they finally get the power play going and have the advantage in the offensive zone. Shot on there by Captain. And that's going to be sent around the boards, but not out. Kept in here. Ridgebacks maintaining pressure until Trent Pekeli is able to clear it down the ice for the Gryphons. Coming through the blue line, that one's going to be cleared away again by the Guelph Gryphons, doing a great job on the power play here. Appio finds McDonald in the middle, can't get the shot away, now Appio does, and that one just sails wide. Now back behind his net is Purves, and Purves plays it off to the wing. Ridgebacks having a lot of trouble playing it out of their zone right now on this power play, which only has 10 seconds remaining. Guelph Gryphons showing great hustle getting to these loose pucks and pressuring the Ridgebacks right now, and it kills off the penalty as the Guelph Gryphons change up their entire lineup. Now come the Ridgebacks back the other way. Shot on, that one just misses wide. Kept in at the blue line, played down into the corner, but that's picked off. Moving back the other way comes Hassan. Hassan misses Jeffries, and that's going to be picked off. Played back the other way, and that misses the intended target and rolls all the way down to the Guelph Gryphon zone. Now Broussard with it. Broussard moving up. Nice outlet pass there for Terry, just couldn't get it. And that was going to be played offside by Jeffries. Faceoff is won here by the Ridgebacks. Played over to the fence and moving up the ice. Good little move across the blue line here, but upended there by Martini. Now played back behind the goal to Martini. Martini, nice outlet pass up the middle for Cousy. Cousy finds Carboneau, finding a streaking Appio. Appio can't get a shot away. As he comes around the net, plays it back to the defense. Martin will just send it into the corner. Now Cousy with it. Cousy on the puck. It's being hounded there, so he's going to cycle it around for Appio. Appio back to the point. Shot there, and that one's going to be deflected wide. Now come the Ridgebacks. Up through center ice with it is Patches. Patches trying to move towards the net. Nice move there. Got around the defense and just couldn't finish. Another errant pass through the middle, way behind Lyle there. This one's going to roll into the zone. Stop behind the net is Maxwell. Now played up the boards, and this one will eventually be corralled by the Gryphons, trying to move it out. Lots of room here as Gavora looks for someone to go to. Gavora trying to slide it far side and just couldn't convert. Now Schwint back behind the net, trying to